The 2017 Development Effectiveness Review of the Asian Development Bank was held Thursday morning as one of the kickoff events of the 51st ADB annual meeting. Planning Secretary Ernesto Pernia was at the review to discuss ADB's performance in terms of assistance to the Philippines.
I think the bank has done relatively little as regards important areas, progressively narrowing the country's huge infrastructure gap. Although it was the focus of the ADB in its early years, including traffic congestion in the National Capital Region. Of course, that is not the ADB's fault, but I'm just saying that in terms of its contribution to these issues.
The Asian Development Bank took the criticism in stride.
Have a little bit of tough love, if you will, from the Philippines. And indeed, I think that there are any number of points that Secretary Pernia made that are very much part of our contemplation in both broadening and deepening our relationship directly with the Philippines, including, you know, I think as he mentioned, you know, addressing these issues of huge infrastructure gaps that continue to hamper growth in the country.
Pernia later admitted his comments were aimed at goading ADB into providing more support for the Philippines. The ADB has averaged over $700 million in lending to the Philippines for the last 10 years. That is 35 billion pesos per year. Still, stakeholders like PCCI Chairman George Barcelon say they don't feel ADB's support.
I actually attended the 50th anniversary in Yokohama, yeah. And I did not also see too much about the Philippines. And institutions like ADB is there to help us in some major projects. There's no harm in having their assistance, but for projects I think that would requires faster deployment, the assistance is being extended by countries that are more aggressive in pursuing big projects would we have to take priority.
ADB's own data show the focus has been more on public sector management, energy, agriculture and rural development, and finance. Transport, water and other urban infrastructure came in after. ADB President Takehiko Nakao says this year they hope to invest more in the Philippines.
We also want to invest more in Mindanao because for the peace, sustaining peace in Mindanao, we need to develop Mindanao in a broader sense. And we had a very big road project in Mindanao last year, but we are also considering the support to transport in Davao.
Nakao also noted they will be aiding in infrastructure development throughout the region with the help of China's Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, or AIIB. The two lenders already co-financed four projects in 2017, with more expected this year.
An interesting start to the 51st annual ADB meeting, and a tough position as well for the lender, which has to cater to 67 member countries, not just the host, the Philippines. There are 4,200 participants in Manila right now, hoping to enlist the aid of the ADB in development initiatives. Perhaps that is why the ADB views China's AIIB as reinforcement rather than rival. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.